The warriors.
Yes, sir.
Conquerors.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Respect.
Respect.
No.
The Almighty has given I and I his hand. His rod of correction I hold.
Mama Maloza.
Mama Muleza.
Let no man here fear for his own life. Them that wish I and I to be left in poverty and squalor will themselves be damned. If a man commit a crime against you, he must be paid back 1,000 times. Who you fear? Him, I mean.
Hello and welcome to another day in paradise. I wanted to do this quick video. I just had a little episode happen which I wanted to fly past you. So I'm doing a little business on the African continent. I've started up a business. I'm not ready to start telling people about it yet. But I needed a shipping company that would ship from Accra over to Zurich in Switzerland. And I figured I would go to this African shop just down the road from me. There isn't many in Zurich, but they do exist. And it's really weird. I've been inside the African shop before. The guy there always gives me weird looks. He doesn't really welcome me with open arms. It's really strange. I get a strange vibe from him when I go inside there normally. But, you know, for me it doesn't matter. I just thought, okay, I need a shipping agent. He owns a little shop. He would be, of course, the best person to ask about this. So I went inside his shop about 30 minutes ago, and I asked him, oh, do you know any shipping companies? And he said, no. That was it. I said, okay, and walked out. Now, it's like he's bullshitting. I don't know why he's bullshitting. It's really strange for him to do something like this. I mean, normally if you would help somebody out, wouldn't you? I mean, I don't understand. Anyway, so I've gone over to another shop on the other side of town. Indian shop. It's an Indian shop. And once again, they have a much larger shop than this African shop, and they sell a whole range of products from the African continent. And I've gone inside there and I've asked, okay, do you know any shipping agents that will ship from Accra, Ghana to Zurich? And they were like, yeah, of course we do. We know them, yeah. We know a few places that you can go and you can ask. We don't know anybody specifically, but we do know people who regularly have a shipping company, and they're agents, and you know, it takes around 22 days. And he gave me a whole range of information, and even got on his smartphone and started speaking to me about which particular agent was the best one. An Indian shop, an Indian man doing this. And I just thought, I was just a little bit confused. I just thought, here I am. I'm like pushing for us to be pro, you know, African, to do everything and live everything through African people. But do they actually want us to do the same? Do they just want us to have... I mean, are they coming over here, opening shops and small businesses and focusing on Europeans? Which would be strange for the shop that I went to earlier, because it's an African shop, right? Selling African products, African hair products, African food, everything to do with Africa. And I looked in his shop. His shop is always empty, by the way. I just thought, are we killing ourselves for this? Are we focusing on the wrong people. You know, does everybody want our help? Does everybody need our help? I think with my experience of what I have found out doing business in the Gambia and in Accra and in Lagos as well, I think it's fair to say that the vast majority of business owners don't really care. They don't care where you come from. If anything, if you're in the diaspora and you go to an African shop, they tend to look at you suspiciously, especially if you look like me, because I do not look like I am from the diaspora. When you first look at me, they look at me and they think I'm an African man who's been living in the diaspora for a while. That's the first thing they think. So it's a strange one. So many Africans who have come over here not long ago and have started their businesses, when they see me, I think they are a little standoffish and a little suspicious because they don't know what tribe I'm from. They don't know my origins, but they do believe that I am African. Now, what happened to me today, you know, I can only put down to the individual. You know, I'm not going to say everybody sort of acts this way, because they don't. I've been to a few African shops and normally they're very nice people and they do welcome me, and they also have a smile for me. And, you know, I'm going to tell you something else as well. Walking around Zurich, if you're, you know, an African diaspora, you're walking around Zurich, everybody smiles at you. If you walk past another African, the first thing they're going to do is wave at you. You're going to greet each other. I have never, ever walked past an African person here in Zurich and that person has not said hello or said hello back to me. It's never happened. Everybody pretty much knows that we're in a boat together and that we need to support each other, especially in one of the whitest countries in the whitest part of this planet. So we all know what the people are going to be like here. So we've only got each other. So I think it's different. I think that this gentleman is perhaps just a one-off. But I think the problem is that you're going to get people who don't deal with the newly arrived Africans, you know, the ones that have only been here for 5-10 years, you know, first generation. You're going to get people who can deal with them for the first time, deal with men like him, and they're going to make the assumption that most newly arrived immigrants are like him, which is sad because they're not. And then they're going to think that they are all that way, because that's the way we think, right? If we have a bad experience with somebody, we normally sort of prey on that bad experience. It's normally the good experiences that we tend to forget real quickly. Yeah. So anyway, I found it weird. It's a little annoying to me, to be honest with you, but I thought I'd share it with you guys because I don't know. What do we get from this? What do I get from this? And what should I tell you? I think you should keep an open mind. You know, keep an open mind. Not everybody thinks like you. Not everybody wants the same thing that you want. Don't look at somebody and think, oh, he's got the same skin color as me, I know what he wants. You can't think that way. You can't think that way. You're setting yourself up for failure. Take everybody for who they are. Respect those who respect you. It's as simple as that. That's the number one rule. Respect those people who respect you. Then take it from there. So, I'm going to leave you with that for today. my thoughts for the day. And yeah, I'll let you know how this business, when this business kicks off, when it starts off, I'll speak more about it. Until then, I'll speak to you in the next one. Ta-ra a bit.